everyone, and welcome to Paula's Soapbox. I'm here with actress Sharon Farrell. Soap fans will recall that Sharon played Florence Webster on The Young and the Restless. She was Nina's mother. But she's had a career that has spanned more than 5 decades. And in that time, she has worked with everyone from James Garner to Chuck Norris. She's just written a book about her life called Sharon Farrell, Princess from Hollywood. No, Hollywood Princess from Sioux City, Iowa. Yes. And she can currently be seen in Broken at Love, the web series. And you can check out every episode on their YouTube channel at youtube.com/brokenatlove. So, welcome, Sharon.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you. And I'm just really happy I'm doing the show with you, because I love your comments and I love your website, Paula's Soapbox. It's .com. It's on Facebook and it's .com.
It's Paula's Soapbox .blogspot.com. It's through Google, so it's kind of a long address. So I just direct people to that from Facebook and Twitter. It's easier.
Yeah. Keep it short and simple.
Right.
You know? Paula's Soapbox. What's the rest of it?
It's on Google, so it's Paula's Soapbox .blogspot. That is Google's like standard address.
The Google sticks that on the end.
Right. So usually, what I do if I have anything new on there, I'll just post a link on Facebook or Twitter, and then no one has to remember the website name. They can just
that's
link.
That's great. But yeah, that's just so great.
Because it's so long, it's hard to remember. You know.
Well, I know.
And it's just, yeah, that's the one thing I don't like about it, because when you sign up for that, for the Google website, that's what they give you. So you're just kind of stuck with it.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, everything's getting better and better.
Mm-hmm.
You know? I just found out on my computer I can talk and it'll, like, do it.
Talk.
Yeah, I can talk and it'll do it, except that it kind of, like, doesn't understand you.
Right.
So.
So it's like autocorrect.
Well, like somewhere, you know, you talk and you send a message, you know, you just like talking and say, "Oh, hi, Paula. What's up? You know, what time are we supposed to get together?
Mm-hmm.
And you know, how is your day going?" And it'll like say, "Apple at the store." You know, it just goes off. You know, and it's got its own thing it wants to do.
Yeah, you have to. I guess you have to speak really slowly and enunciate.
Yeah, well, I think it has to get used to your voice.
Too. Yeah.
Something like that.
It's kind of like that Siri that's on the Apple smartphones, the iPhones and the iPads. Do you know that?
Where you... Yeah, I got scared. I got an iPad 5. I mean, not an iPad.
iPhone.
5. Mm-hmm. And that thing just scared the dickens out of me. I just took it right back.
Right.
It's too much for me. I'm too old. I can't do this. I just can't do it. Now I'm getting to like where I'm thinking I'm gonna have to, you know, I've got to jump in. I can't be saying no to anything.
Right. Well, you know? And you know, you didn't think you could do Twitter either, and you're getting the hang of that. And
I know. I don't understand like the hash when you do the hash when you do the pound.
That's not something you have to do. That's more like if there's a specific topic that you are talking about, you can put like the pound sign and that topic, and if a lot of people are talking about that same topic, it becomes a trending topic. So it sort of keeps track of who's talking about what.
Yeah, but it seems like they're like, they do the thing and then they put somebody's name.
Yeah, it's basically anything anyone wants to put in there. And so, like, say if somebody's talking about Broken at Love and they put the pound sign Broken at Love, if someone wanted to see what everyone else was saying about Broken at Love, they could just click on where somebody else had put that hashtag Broken at Love and it'll bring up all these tweets.
I keep referring to Broken at Love as just broken.
Broken.
Because you know what I mean? It's like so hard to write a
Right.
You know, I want to keep everything really. I want things so simple. And
Twitter's one of those things where
Gregory Hall with that geek conspiracy.
The geek Remember, supremacy project.
Yeah, it's like what is? I thought he was Greek or something.
Yeah.
You know, maybe there was Greek or his dad was Greek, and it was like some conspiracy with the United States and what that was. But now it's Gregory Hall, which I like much more.
Right. Oh, the sound just went out. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I
can hear you now. It was like you just got muted for a second. I don't know what happened.
The wind blew.
Probably.
We were talking about Gregory Hines. I'm thinking like maybe some...
Ooh, yeah. Some right.
God wanted to talk about that or something. Oh, what did we say?
Yeah, I like the Gregory Hall show. I think that sounds good. I think that's a good...
Yeah.
And it's easy to remember.
Yeah. And I think he gives some good advice. I like that when he was like saying, you know, how does a guy handle it when girls are all over him and you're married? You know, he says, I go home.
Go home. Yeah.
So
can't get in trouble if you're home.
And then he says, you know, he comes up with these things every once in a while that are really good, you know. And... it was so funny when Carolina said, well, if you were going to take me out, how would you come on? Renee said that. Renee said, how would you come in? How would you try to pick up? And he says, well, I'll just go over there and just, you know, I don't know. He gave some, like, kind of despair. He kind of like, well, I don't think that looks very good on you. Or he said something like that, you know. And then he walked away, and I said, well, what do you expect her to do, chase you down the block?
Right.
He's like, it's like, he doesn't want to play that role. He doesn't want to play a role where he said, oh, I'm not, I wouldn't put up with that kind of stuff. I'm not going to put up with that. You know?
Right. I don't want to play that game or something like that.
I know.
Carolina was like, what game? What are you talking about? I don't go in for that, or I don't go after that life or something like that.
Style a girl or somebody who's shopping for Chanel work boots, you know, or whatever, you know, can you imagine Chanel? They probably do have them there.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a good episode.
She's such a little fashion plate, you have no idea.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw some of the shoes that she brought on one of the shows, the ones that she, I think it was the ones that she wore in the first episode, the red heels that she couldn't stand in. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, she.
Oh, she's got some shoes, that girl. Really
I would does. Break my neck in shoes like that.
Well, I can, you know, I was a dancer, and I, you know, all that point work.
Mm-hmm.
I had to have 5 bones taken out of each foot because I was up on those toes and, you know, dancing for so long. Mm-hmm. And then 8 carries on. And Nev Campbell and I were both having our feet operated on the same day when we used to go to the doctor.
Mm-hmm.
This guy who, and he really literally he'd do 1 foot and you were walking. You mm-hmm. walked out of it. You know, he was a really good doctor. I can wear really high heels, you know, for my age,
mm-hmm.
be something like that. But I, you know, these
are Crocs.
and before that, I was wearing ballet slippers, but I don't know. They kind of, I don't know. You kind of have to change shoes, I think, for your feet. It's like shampoo. You use shampoo for a while. And all of a sudden, your hair is kind of dull and listless. You got to change shampoo.
Right.
And, but I get attached to shoes. I get attached to purses and stuff.
Yeah, and you kind of get used to wearing one thing, and it's just so easy to just slip them on. And you know, if I get used to a pair of tennis shoes, then it's hard for me to switch to, you know, something less comfortable.
Fun that would go with everything. Like, as, you know, it's like as you get older, the worst thing you can do is fall. Mm-hmm. You know, you can't fall. Even when you're young, you can't fall. I mean, when you fall, you hurt yourself, you know. Mm-hmm. Fall down the stairs or, you know, if you fall, you know, it's not a good thing.
Yeah, you fall just right, you can do a lot of damage.
But I'll tell you something. It's like I was watching, thinking about shoes for dancers. I have to give these people that do these dance shows up. So You Think You Can Dance, or what's the show where the celebrities come in and dance?
Dancing with the Stars.
Dancing with the Stars, okay. Mm-hmm. You see these people rehearsing, and they're rehearsing in their tennis shoes.
Mm-hmm.
Cannot do that. You got to rehearse in the shoes you're going to wear.
Yeah, see, I've always wondered about that, too, because it doesn't make sense.
From tennis shoes into, like, any kind of a heel, any kind of a shoe, it's a different feel. You cannot mm-hmm. do that.
Yeah, I've always wondered about that.
All the girls out there that are going to be doing Dancing with the Stars, rehearse in the shoes you're going to wear.
Yeah. Would you ever do something like that, Dancing with the Stars?
What? I've been paid to dance, but I don't think I can. Because I did My Three Sons, and I played a ballerina because... Robbie on My Three Sons his coach sent him to ballet lessons.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was supposed to be his girlfriend, and they wanted me to do the show, but I turned it down, and Shelley Fabre did it.
Mm-hmm.
Because I wanted to be a movie star, you know. I didn't want to do a series. You know, I just didn't want to, you know, I just looked down on TV. I was a little snobby brat, you know.
Yeah.
And, I turned that down. And also, my love life was crazy. I was dating Vince Edwards, who had Ben Casey, and that was like the most popular show in the world. I was also seeing Dean Stockwell, that I had had a crush on since The Secret Garden.
Mm-hmm.
Dean Stockwell was a child actor, and he was just, I just loved him. I mean, I had a crush on him since I was a little girl.
Rod.
I was seeing both of them, and I don't know, it was like, you know, doing My Three Sons seemed so, you know, the guy that was playing my boyfriend seemed like he was, like, young, because I was going out with these older men, you know. I don't know. It's just, I just did something wrong. But at the same time, if I hadn't done what I did, I might have stepped on a crack and broken my mother's back and my own as well and could be dead.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like I'm here, so I must have done everything right.
Right. Well, you know, and you, I'm sure you learned from all those experiences, too, so.
No, because no. I'll tell you, I had to drive to Pasadena,
mm-hmm.
when it was for a product, and I thought, well, I'll try it, you know, I'll try it, and if it works, I would do it, but they wanted to pay me $50 a day. Now, for me to drive to Pasadena is an hour. I drive back, the gasoline, and buy my own lunch. I'm not going to make any money, and God only knows I'm going to be selling a product that maybe I don't want to be a spokesperson for some product that I really don't believe in.
Right.
Jennifer Aniston. How do you pronounce her name?
Aniston. Jennifer Aniston. Yes.
Jennifer Aniston, she's doing these things on Aveeno.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm thinking, I'm sure that she, like, uses this.
Mm-hmm.
But why would she do that? She doesn't need the money.
No.
So she really believe in it. So I bought one. But mm-hmm. I haven't really given it a real test yet.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to,
That's what I use. Aveeno, that's what I use.
You like it?
Mm-hmm. I like it. I think it does a really good job of like a lot of lotions, you use them, and they're good until they...
That rolls up, and it, you got... You know,
yeah,
you
no, this is not like that. Yeah.
And then you rub it in, and then all of a sudden, you're rubbing it off.
Right.
A little dark ball.
I haven't noticed that with the Aveeno. So, yeah. I mean, I like it. I think it works pretty good.
I thought she was, like, cool, and she always had a good hairstyle, and, you know, I kind of, you know, it's like, if I were a young girl, I would like Jennifer. I mean, the little girl in me is, like, I'm a fan of her.
Right.
You know?
You want to be Jennifer Aniston when you grow up.
Yeah, when I grow up, I want